Scuba Scoop is sponsored by
Get Nana Habo Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.
Yesterday was Independence Day. We were celebrating 56 years as an independent nation. Don't ask me what independence means. Because everybody had their own interpretation of independence and what it means to them and what these 56 years mean to them. I had a chance. I sat down with people who are way, way older, who are not in this generation, and they gave me their side of independence. Then I asked my millennials and they gave me their side. So I decided, you know what? I'm going to mix you all up and meet each one of you halfway, because everyone is pretty much sentimental. But hey, a happy 56th independence to Uganda. And yes, it's Scoop and Scoop. This episode is proudly sponsored by Nana Habo Mouthwash. Get the product, try the product. Let's delve into some gossip. So let's start off the gossip with Rema's new song. Rema has a new song. It's called Siri Muyembe. Now, I know there's a lot that's happening in the world of Eddie Kenzo and Rema. We ran a story last week. Was it last week or on Monday? I think it was on Monday. But like the rumors have been extremely rife. Everybody has a different opinion. If it's true, if it's not true, if it's concocted, or if they're just trying to sell Rema anew. But anyway, there's trouble in paradise, according to the people that are closest to the source. There is definitely trouble in paradise when it comes to Eddie Kenzo and Rema's marriage. Both are not pretty much saying anything outrightly until Rema did this song. The song is called Siri Muyembe, but I haven't seen a video yet. Na yem politics are lyrical content. Ningamba, hey! Chika Kenzo! Chika! Chica. Now, in the words of this song, it literally felt like this is not just some song that they sat down and wrote for her. You can definitely feel that this is a song she had to sit down and be part of the process of, because it really, really evokes Rema. Now, how I know Rema is singing from the heart. There are times when Rema sings from the heart. That is when you know she had something to do with the entire writing process. There are times when Rema just decides, in these lyrics, she talks about Siri Muyembe. It was too much, but literally speaking, all I got from it is this is a cry for attention from Kenzo. Probably it could be. I could just be one of those songs that, you know, they decided to drop at this moment when everything seems to not be going well in regards to the Lugambo circles. But then that would be too intricately put together. I do not see Rema's team and Eddie Kenzo's team coming up with such... No, this could be real. Y'all need to listen to this song. Now, the Chinese Yamuchidi, Kumintu Bibidi, Rema Yagarach. Aida Yagarabu Fumbo, Mbage Mpeta Koyo Kulinda. Obasiche Chomutage Mbe. But all in all, all I have seen about this song is Rema is directly targeting these words to someone in particular. Now, given the fact that we all know she's dating Eddie Kenzo, ooh, child, it's going to be an interesting 2018 after all. It's going to go, ooh. Anyway, Siri Muyembe mugende muluulirize, kyakanze Justin njagala byonoonese naye ng'ekituufu kiri nti omwana abyogedde ate kano katandika butandisi. Yesterday was a public holiday, which meant people worked Monday like half day, and then we had parties! We had Major Lazer in the city. They killed it. They couldn't have killed it any further. Like, they flogged it. That was beautiful. And then we had Kenneth Mugabe. We were official sponsors. And as a sponsor, I have never seen that much happiness in one room. He sold out. He really did. Everything went fine. I cannot begin talking about what bad things happened there, because if there's something wrong that happens at an acoustic show, ngomanye bintu bibi nyo musi. So I know you all read that story. There's a Ugandan, she's studying at Harvard, innit? And she decided to get married to herself. Reason, she says, every time her parents come, like, give her a phone call, they're like, girl, you are marriage age. What's happening? Are you getting married anytime soon? Like, she was tired of the relatives, and she was tired of society putting that pressure on her that she's way too old, her clock is ticking, she's supposed to be having kids and a relationship and a career. She was like, wait, slow your role. It's my life. It's my life. So what did she do? She up sticks, went and got married to herself. So wait, Nindako, how does that work? I go to court and I tell the judge, hey, judge, I'm gonna marry me. Do you marry the second person or the third person? Because I usually like to speak to my second person, because there's me, myself, and I. I love me. Me is good. I is a little bit messed up. I would so totally understand. Everyone came out and they're like, that's madness, it's garbage, it's rubbish. You see, you millennials, that's what you're doing. Y'all is taking these liberties to a whole nother level. I was like, wait. If the chick sat down and honestly looked at all of it, I was just like, nah, yeah, fudge. Because let's face it, everything is messed up lately. Relationships come with way too much drama, way too much stress. The guys are expecting to marry Nanduja, Nakarembe, Agasa. You know, there are those ones in the village, they call Agasa. Not Agatha, no, Agasa. So it's a little bit confusing. If you have a relationship right now and it's working for you, good for you. You're among the lucky few. If you're one of those people who is trying to get into a relationship at this time of the year, with this type of people around, I mean, I wish you luck. And for all of you who are out there just mingling, don't forget to make sure you test and hepatitis. Anyway, it is what it is. Chick decided to get married to herself. She says now that she's done that, she's now going to move ahead, do her books, have a career. Wait, so when you marry yourself, do you tell the other hand I do? Wait, so when you marry yourself, this hand dresses up, puts the ring on this one when you marry yourself. Oh, and yeah, before I can say bye-bye, I happen to be watching national television. You know what that means. If you watch the show, you know what that means. And Desire Lucinda was seated down with Caritas and they were sharing, they were having their one-on-one, and it's about to kill me. Desire Lucinda broke down when asked about her ordeal with her licked nudes from a man she trusted. She just, it was so much. Lol, I am so hopeless. I was looking at this girl like, child, you better wipe them fake tears off you, just as fake as your nails that are wiping the tears off you. Shut up. It was all planned. We're not that stupid. You've made a lot of money from it. Let it go. And then, of course, she talked about how she's with the pastor who said he cannot let a ganja man rule him when they're able-bodied people. Yeah, she's with that church. She says, I fellowship now. I'm even singing in the choir. I was looking at Desire like, good for you. Good for you. You know, Bobo Mazeo, all the tricks in the book. You have to look for something original. Desire has done did it. You know, she's done all of it. She has walked around naked. We have talked. She has sung useless music. We have talked. She has slept with too many people. We have talked. Now, she reached the point, I think, and she's like, wait, they don't care no more. Akaduka teka chatunda. Bada bali na homework. Holiday package. Have you seen Kampala girls? Abi, have you met Kampala girls? Ish. So now she decided to just take it to Christ. Happy for her, but that bull crap of... Oh my God. Why you didn't cry on BBC? Was it BBC CNN? When they were freshly dropped, she was like, girl, please. It's been how many years? 3 years. You're still shaken by that ish. You made way too much money to be shaken by some idiot. Because he was nothing but an idiot who decided to quit. He decided he loved you too much. He wanted to share you with the rest of the world if he can't have you alone. And now you're supposed to be a stronger woman than this. Way, way stronger. You're the type of people who make people look at us like weaklings. We have the strength to lift up an entire nation as women. And you're on camera, still crying and showing the person who put up all your notes that you are still offended. Our page is strictly for Lugambo. But you meet Lugambo, send in all those things, all those, you know, stories on Scoop and Scoop or Tina Fias. You're giving us numbers of witch doctors. And now for you who are sending this ish, are in London. I'm like, mwe. Witch doctors, mutanise no bate kamwe nyonyi. And this episode was proudly sponsored by Nana Herbal Mouthwash. Don't forget, on Instagram, it's a Tina Fierce one with an H. I lie, you lie, you lie. You catch you again tomorrow on a Thursday where we just might review a video or two. I'm out. Peace.
Scoop and Scoop was sponsored by
Get Nana Herbal Mouthwash and your problems will be no more.